Hi. How many people had never seen that before? Okay. Yay. I've seen it a few times. So Any questions? Yeah. The question is, do you go back and watch it and think you could have done anything better? Yeah, I think there's something about the way that he gets up and leaves that I think could be stronger. There's something about like him making a decision to take the risk or the circumstances around that. I can't put my finger on it, but this one I feel like pretty happy about. I've done a few projects, and this one I feel like is the most dialed in. So I don't have a lot of those like wishes that things would be different, but I'm sure there's always something. I think in retrospect, the music was something that I was really worried about, and it didn't show up for a long time, and I was getting more and more worried about it. And then finally, when it did show up, I was like, yes, because it was so much better than I had ever dreamed it could be. And it served the story and this kind of exuberance of these people being drawn together with this magic was like so well served by the ending track. And it felt fresh and modern. And in that case, I have zero regrets, you know, about stuff like that. I'm just feel lucky that I got to work with somebody who understood it that well. But anyone else? Yeah? Oh, over here.
We always encourage filmmakers to use the short film as a calling card to express their style and to use it as a way to market themselves as they go to international festivals. What about Paperman is your calling card? What was the thing that you really feel is personal to you and is the thing that is you on screen?
Well, I think I talked about it before that I was kind of bored with animation and the way it looked. And so I was really pushing this idea that we could make animation that looked really different and look really good too. But I also felt like I knew how to create rhythm and shots as a director. I knew how to direct animation because I'm an animator. But I think the most important thing was like I wanted to create emotion. I wanted to create like a clarity of emotion, and I wanted to sweep you away with emotion, and I felt like this short accomplished that. And yeah, that's all I could say about it.
Wonderful to see the film again, John. It's so beautiful. And I'm very interested to know, because of the process of working with both 2D and 3D animators, how did you manage the decision-making process and the poses? Because when you watch the behind the scenes, it looks like the 2D animators are pushing what the 3D animators kind of gave them. So was it quite a lot of back and forth? How did you kind of decide on how to go with
we had to build a pipeline that made sense to somebody somewhere. So we built a pipeline that started with 3D and it got finished in animation in 3D. In terms of the movement and the polish of the movement, we were done. And even the expressiveness of the characters and the acting was all done in 3D. And then it went into lighting to get it prepared for the draw over. And then I think the draw over artists were just pushing what they felt naturally that they wanted to push. So we learned really quickly that, you know, the profile of a sleeve, for instance, is something that not only did they want to add onto it, but they wanted to carve away from. So we changed the software to allow them to cut into it. But yeah, that was the process. I think that you're going to get a lot of really good taste from experienced 2D animators. Like we had this discussion about the eye pupils. Should they have a pupil and an iris and a highlight and they're like, no, it's a black disc, it's a circle, that's it. I was really, is that simple? And then I think I have more and more in my career, I'm like, why are the eyes so ridiculously complicated? If they're just a black circle, you just infer so much emotion into the simplicity of it. you fall right into it in terms of like the depth. And I think that when I see things like Polar Express is a good example of eyes that are overdone and hard to read and overcomplicated. And that's not the only one, but I would say simpler is better for eyes, just as a side note. So that's it. Okay. Thanks, everybody. Really appreciate it.